Good morning, my great students. You are welcome to government class. How are you today? Settle down and bring out your writing materials. I hope you will enjoy this class. Today, the topic we are considering is political parties. Political parties. But before we go on, let's look at the objectives of this topic. By the end of the lesson, you should be able to explain the organizational structure of a political party. You should be able to discuss the functions of political parties. And, of course, you should be able to highlight the factors that determines the success of a political party. But let us look at the corrections of assignment for the previous lesson on colonial administration. Question 1. Discuss two negative and positive impacts of colonial administration in West Africa. The answers. Negative impacts. 1. Colonialism failed to advance Africa along the path of human resources. That is, the African human resources was not optimally utilized. It was a negation of freedom. It could not possibly bring modern political liberation to Africans. So it was like then modern slavery or slave trade part 2, because it was a negation of freedom. Let's now look at the positive impacts. The uniform civil service was developed along that of the British and the French systems. And colonialism brought Christianity. That is, the introduction of Christianity tended to break the societies which the traditional religions had united. Question 2. Compare and contrast the administrative policy in the British and French territories. Let us consider the comparison between British and French systems. The first one says, Britain allowed the formation of political associations in her colonies. But France opposed and suppressed the formation of political parties. British indirect rule was a system of decentralization because they allow our traditional rulers and some Africans to be part of their administration. But the French was highly centralized because they felt that their own culture is more advanced than other cultures in the world. Let's now look at the differences among the two administrations. Unlike the French, British were not interested in making Britons of the citizens of their territories. That is, where British colonized in West Africa. They were not interested in making people there to be like them. They were also not interested in integrating the culture of their territories with that of Britain. Now, let's go to today's topic, political party. What is a political party? The definition. A political party is an organized group of citizens who act together as a political unit, having distinctive aims and objectives, involving political questions in the state, and acting together and seeking to obtain control of government. That is a political party. When you see a political party, the first thing that should come to your mind is that a political party is an organized group of citizens who act together as a political unity or entity, having distinctive, that is, their aims and objectives are far, far, far different from other groups. Their own aims and objectives involve political questions in the state, and they act together and seeking to obtain the control of a government. That's why political parties, they are different from pressure groups. It is also defined as an association of like-minded persons who organize themselves into a political group for the purpose of controlling political power, not just power, but political power, power to rule a country, power to rule a state, and the administrative machinery of a state, that is, the working force behind the running of a state. So all these are embedded in a political party, in case if such party eventually voted into what? Into power. These are a few examples of the political parties in Nigeria. You can see their logo and their acronyms: APC, APGA, PDM, PDP, Labour, ADC, PPA, to mention but a few. Nigeria registered, INEC registered 96 political parties during the last election, and they are trying to narrow them down just to reduce them. So they are still working on that. Now, let's look at the organizational structure of a political party. We are going to start with the smallest unit, that is called ward. This comprises of the officials like a chairman, secretary, and treasurer. Ward is a smaller unit of the party structure, at the smallest one, that are very close, the wards are very closer to us. Then let's look at the branches. There are local government branches throughout the country, if the party is a very strong party with mass followership. Of course, such party will have branches all over the country. Another, look at this picture of the APC candidate's political campaign. This is Professor Oyemi Osinbajo. This is President Muhammadu Buhari and other APC members showcasing their brooms as their symbol of their party. Let's continue. Another one is a constituency branches. This one also includes chairman, organizing secretary, treasurer, affiliation. There are other affiliated bodies. That one can be youth wing. That one can be women leader, women league. You know, they are just subsidiaries of that political party, and they are being affiliated to that party to be part of that party. We also have a regional or state branches which coordinate the activities of all constituency branches. So another structure. Let's look at the PDP. This is the picture. Another picture. Picture of the PDP candidates political campaign. You can see the branded vehicles of Atiku for the campaign. This is Jonathan and the Fais, Namadi, Sambu, during their own time. These are the branded vehicles. These are the flags of the party. And also, you will see the wristband. So, that's just wristbands. Let's continue. There's also what we call National Conference. This is responsible for National Delegates Conference. Anytime the Conference of National Delegates is coming off, so they call it National Conference. And also, there's what we call National Working Committee. This committee makes decisions or deal with a particular subject or subject matter in the party. So another one is the National Secretariat. This is responsible for running the affairs of the party. If you want to, if you want to see one of the APC secretariat, when you are going along Ijayi, after Jankara, so when you are going to Ijayi, after Jankara, just keep to your right. You will see one of the APC's secretariat there. Another one is a National Executive Committee. This is responsible for preparing or drawing up the policies and programs of the party, and equally coordinates the activities at the local level. And you have Board of Trustees. Board of Trustees. This board controls financial affairs of the party. And there's what we call General Convention or Congress. This is just a large formal meeting or series of meetings where representatives from different groups make decisions. It is also the gathering of members to elect candidates for different elections, e.g. presidential and governorship. Anytime election is coming, they will organize this kind of convention or congress just to elect their candidate, their flag bearer, who will contest with other candidates from other parties. Having said that, let's now look at the functions and importance of political parties. What are the functions and the importance of political parties? One, unity. Political parties unite the people on major issues affecting the state. It will bring people together, just to unite them on major issues affecting the state. Also, political party serves as a link between the people and government. People cannot just reach the government. So, political party, serve as that link, between people and government. Accountability is another function or importance of the party, of political parties. This enable the government to become accountable to the electorate through constructive criticism of the government in power. So if the government in power is being criticized, they will try to brace up, to meet the yearning, the needs of the people, the electorate, what they are promised in their manifestos. If constructive criticism should come up, So government will wake up today to its responsibility, and at the same time, we have control of the government. Political parties exist to contest elections. Not only that, just to and to control the government. Opposition. Another importance of political parties is just to do what? Political parties provide opposition to the ruling party, e.g. PDP, APC. PDP is a major opposition to APC, the ruling party. Also, political education. Political parties provide political education through lectures, symposia, manifestos, and other social programs. They organize rallies, campaigns, lectures, debates, and symposia on government programs and their activities just to keep people informed. Now, let's look at the types of political parties, branch, or mass parties. So this type of party cut across tribes, interest groups, and individuals. People wishing to become members are free to join. The manifesto of such parties are directed towards the welfare of the people. So, if you wish to become a member, you can simply join this party. It's open to everybody. Another one is a caucus or elite parties. From the name elite, you know that this party, you know, is made up of a people of the upper class in the society. And these people believe that the control of government should be their preserve and should be in the hands of those with distinction and of high intellectual standing, just as the name implies. And another one is religious parties. So this one exists where religious doctrines, you know, existing in a country determine the formation. You know, the religious doctrine of existing in the country determine the formation of these parties. Like e.g. Iran, you know, Iran knows is not to be a Muslim country. Vatican City is not to be, you know, Catholic and Roman, the headquarter of a Roman Catholic in the world, in Rome. So the doctrine of this existing in a country determines this particular party. Broker party is another one. This is a party of both the rich and the poor. They work towards bridging the gap between the rich and the poor and promoting equality and welfare of the people. Charismatic party. Individuals with unique and enviable qualities, talents, etc. can form these parties. People are attracted to these parties because of the charisma of those individuals that form them. You know, when we say charisma, it means, you know, unique qualities, talents about some people or somebody. So people are, you know, attracted to this kind of party because of the charisma of those individuals that form them. Now, let's look at another subtopic: factors which determine the electoral success of a political party. That is, factors that guarantees the electoral success of a political party at the poll, at elections. One, manifesto. If a party has a good manifesto, this may produce overwhelming support for the party at elections. We will still talk more about manifesto in the next topic, you know, party systems. Another one is realistic past performance. A good track record of a political party may give it an edge over others. That is, the record of a particular political party in the past to the president can, no, give such party, can make such party to have an edge over others. So this is a short video of APC presidential campaign. So I want you to sit back and watch it to just to view how president how political campaign or presidential campaign or campaign of any political party, how their campaign looks like. Now, spread membership is another one that can guarantee a party success at election. That is, a political party with followership across the society has more chances of victory at the polls. Another one is organization. A well-planned organizational structure can also produce better chances for party at election. When a party is well organized with good plans, can give such party, better chances for, at election. Leadership quality, that is, if the leaders of a political party are capable and they have vision, the party can make a headway at the polls. That is, if those leaders are calculative, if they are visionaries, they can project, through their projection, they will sell the party, and the party, will make a headway at the polls ahead of others. And the quality of candidates the type of candidates presented by a party to contest elections may make or mar the party's chances at the poll. Look at what happened, in Bayelsa. APC had already won the election, and they later found out that the deputy governor presented fake certificate. So, and the court decided that they should withdraw the, the certificate from the governor, and PDP candidate emerged as the governor. The same thing is also warming up in Edo State, because there was allegation against the governor, sitting governor, that he presented wild results, and they are also, there was allegation that even the certificate he claimed to possess from University of Ibadan, that the certificate was fake. So, and if that one eventually become true, that means it can mar the chances of a APC at the poll if care is not taken. Adequate funding. A party with a non-fund can organize best campaigns, rallies, by engaging the services of an advertising agency for a well-produced party emblem, jingles, etc. This may help in recording successes at the polls. And also party patronage. If a political party can win the support of some organizations, wealthy or influential individuals in the society, its chances at the polls may be enhanced. So, the caliber of people, the type of people, organizations, that pledge their support for a particular party, will determine the chances of such party at the polls. Now, let's look at the problems of political parties. Anti-party activities is number one. Some party members are disloyal, and they get themselves involved in anti-party activity. That is, activities that are not in conformity with their what? Party. So that one has been, you know, a problem over time. Problem on the political parties. Another one, irresponsible acts on the part of the leaders. You know, some of them are not responsible. Many of them were imposed on party members or faithfuls. You know, they were not the choice of the people, but they are just being imposed. And they are not responsible. That can also be a problem of political parties. Another one is political parties are always guilty of nepotism, bribery, corruption, and favoritism. Inadequate funding has over time affected the smooth running of mostly the small parties and their successes as the polls. A party with inadequate funding, you know, may be struggling, you know, for success at the poll. Another one, imposition of ideas and candidates on political parties by influential members. So when party try to impose ideas or candidates, you know, on the party members, you know, because they are somehow wealthy or influential, it can pose a problem for such political party. Now, let us look at what we have learned so far. You know, I told you political party is, you know, an organized group of persons in a country. You know, they are also people of like-minded people whose intention is just to win an election and to control the government. And also, you know, I've told you the structure, organizational structure of a political party, you know, ward, convention, congresses, affiliation, you know, to mention but a few. And the problems of political parties like anti-party, corruption, nepotism, favoritism, irresponsible acts on the part of the party leaders, you know. And the functions of political party importance, accountability, you know, just to serve as a link between people and government, and also control of government, to mention but a few. So this has taken us to the reference materials. So to read further, you can get Essential Government for Senior Secondary School by Chris Dibie, and also Near Approach Government for Senior Secondary Schools by Oyedeyan. So this is the assignment. You have to submit this in the next class. Number one, explain the organizational structure of a political party. List three functions of political parties. Three, summarize five factors which determine the electoral success of a political party. And then lastly, give five problems of political parties. Thank you for having me, and thank you for listening. See you next time. Bye bye.